Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. Welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. If you're brand new and if you're a regular, welcome back. So in today's video, we are diving into Google Tasks for iOS. I wanted to talk about the application as well as share a little bit about the web version as well. And the web version isn't exactly available in full. However, the Gmail extension does provide pretty much a window into that experience. So today I'm going to be showing you the iOS version, going through some of my opinions on the application. And I'm actually going to do a separate video recommended by one of you guys all about Google ecosystem, because that has dramatically changed maybe in the last month or so, especially with the introduction of new Gmail and also sort of like the extensions they've brought to the experience. So we will be discussing that, do not worry. Now, just before we jump into this video, guys, make sure to claim 2 months of free Skillshare below. Skillshare is a great resource for workshops and learning something new, so I'll include that link below. So guys, Google Tasks for iOS, it is pretty much the same experience on Android. Just a note, I will be getting an Android phone soon, so more Android reviews will be coming. So Google Tasks is trying to keep it very simple. When you go onto the application, you have the options of obviously seeing a variety of lists that you have. So you may have pre-created a few lists in the past on Gtasks. They might have been transferred over. I know some of mine have, and it's something that I'm not really sure works really great on this application. So once you start out with something called My Tasks, which is a list that they pre-create for you, which will allow you to add a few tasks. Now, hitting the Add New Task button at the bottom will be able to add a task, and you can add some simple task text, and using the plus button in that left-hand corner, you can add almost like a description to some extent, some like notes or details below each task, as well as adding a due date or a completion date, which will allow you to schedule an item on, which works absolutely brilliantly. And once you've got them, obviously adds it to the list. I've obviously created a multitude of lists. You can add more lists and have different lists running. In the past, I actually used, weirdly, I think Gmail task, an actual email as a task, but that was a long, long time ago, like maybe even 3 or 4 years ago, and I'm not sure how they brought that in, but they are available through the application. I think that that's something they will do, focus more on creating tasks through Gmail emails, and that's sort of like a bit of my thoughts in the ecosystem. But within a task, you can actually change lists, so if you're like, okay, I've accidentally created it in this one, you need to switch it, quickly switch it over. That's all possible. You can add a date as well as subtasks. Now, of course, these subtasks work very similar to, I would say, the Microsoft to-do steps, the new edition, and they work really simply. But once you're on that sort of home view or the list view, you actually see the subtasks and there's no actual option to minimize them. So you will see actually the subtask below each of the tasks. Now this actually works fine, and it does what it says on the tin, if you know what I mean. Now one thing I would say I really like about this application is the design. It's really clean, it's really simple. If you're looking for something dead simple, then this might be the application for you. Especially the, I'm not sure whether it's Roboto design of the text, or maybe it's just Google's own font. I'm really behind on their fonts at the moment, but it looks great. And especially the illustrations on the lists that are empty, or when you get to complete all of the tasks, which I'll show you in a sec, just looks fantastic. So that's one of the additions. Now on the right-hand side, you can sort by my order. So that's how what fixed order you had initially, and also by date. You can also rename the list, delete list, or even delete all the completed items. So one note is that when you've completed a task, it comes up almost as like a pinned complete tab inside of your list, and you can open it up and see the tasks that have been completed. I quite like this. I think it's quite a nice addition to some extent, but you can delete all of those really, really easily, so it's great. Now, if you want to, you can, of course, use another account by obviously going over to the left-hand menu bar and actually doing that. And, of course, you can add any new tasks that you do want. But this application, as I was saying to many people, is dead simple. There's really not much to it. The web application replicates pretty much a similar experience, but what I quite like about it above the experience on iOS is that you've obviously got that there. Now, the syncing abilities seem to work great, and having the calendar nearby, this is something I will talk more about in the Google ecosystem conversation, is you can access a calendar right there. So if you're like, okay, actually, when do I need to do those things? You can access it all in one. And now, naturally, many people have asked, does Google Tasks challenge the likes of Google Keep? Now, of course, Google Keep it does have checklist functionality and, to some extent, reminder functionality, allowing you to, you could potentially have a checklist with a reminder on it. And many people have obviously used that for task management for the last, like, maybe three years, I think it is, since it got properly released, three, 4 years. So many people have been using that as a default, but now I would say this will take any of the task management out of it. Apart from maybe checklists, like let's say you're going on holiday, you can of course keep that in Google Keep. But my theology around it and my personal thoughts are that Google Keep should be for your note-taking now, with the idea that it's almost like post-it notes. Like, not all of the time would I put tasks on post-it notes, but Google Tasks is your checklist, your to-do list for the morning. So it allows you to actually see what needs to get done, versus Keep is more of a referencing experience now. So that's a sort of paradigm shift that they've had there. But I would say that, how does Google Tasks compare to Microsoft To-Do? I would say Google Tasks is slightly behind, only because inside of Microsoft To-Do, they have this My Day experience, as well as the ability to suggest My Day tasks. And I think that's slightly above what the experience in Google Tasks has. I would say Google Tasks is like a clean cut version of Microsoft To-Do. To some extent, I would put it slightly lower only because of that. The customizations are really not there, where Microsoft To-Do does have the ability to actually change theme and change and add emoji and things like that. Of course, you can add emoji in this, but I think it's really simple. Like, I think Google Tasks, them not actually releasing it fully on web yet, actually explains, you know, they are in that stage where they are practicing whether they should fully release it. So they're my thoughts on Google Tasks for iOS, as well as a little bit for web there. I hope you have some comments and opinions, because I'd really love to hear them. I will be doing that Google ecosystem one very soon, so do stay tuned for that, guys, because I do think that's a really interesting conversation. But I definitely will be talking very soon about that sort of whole thing. If you haven't seen the Gmail update, I've done a video on that one, so do check that one out. It'll probably appear after the end credits. But I would just want to thank you guys for another episode. Hopefully you got all the information. If you liked it, hit the like button. If you want to subscribe if you want. But it'd be great to have you here back again too. Anyway, guys, thanks very much. Make sure to check out the free 2 months free subscription to Skillshare Premium. So do check that out. But apart from that, guys, have a great weekend. And I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.